Okay, we're going to do topic 2.5 today. I can subtract decimals. And if you know how to subtract whole numbers, you can subtract decimals. So here's our question. 5 and 9 tenths minus 4 and 37 hundredths. Now let's not forget that an answer to a subtraction problem is called a difference. So we're actually finding the difference between those two numbers. So I have it step by step on what you're going to do. The first step is you're going to estimate. And this is a way for us to check our answer. So we can just round it to the whole number. So 5.9 rounds to 6, 4 and 37 hundredths. Think of $4.37. We have close to $4. So when we subtract 6 minus 4, our answer should be about 2. We're going to come back to that when we get to the answer and see if we're right. Because sometimes we forget to put the decimal or we put the decimal in the wrong spot. So estimating is a good way to help us check the answer. Then what we're going to do is we're going to step 2, line up the decimals. So remember the Bubble Guppy song. So we put the ones in the ones place, the tenths in the tenths, and there's nothing up here. So that's actually part of step 3. We can add a zero just to line everything up, just like we were when we were comparing decimals. We can add as many zeros as we want after the decimal. So it helps us to subtract. So after we line them up, step 3 is to circle the sign. And the reason why I circle the sign is because sometimes we're going to have addition problems. Sometimes we're going to have subtraction problems. And a lot of times people get it wrong when we subtract when we're supposed to add or vice versa. So circle the sign helps us to remember that we're subtracting. And then I added a zero here so that way everything's lined up. And then step 4 is we're going to subtract. So we actually can't take 7 from 0. So we're going to have to borrow. We borrow from the 9, that becomes an 8, and then we give that 1 to the 0. So now we can subtract. Now it's 10 minus 7, which is 3. 8 minus 3 is 5. 5 minus 4 is 1. And then step 5 would be drop the anchor, or bringing down the decimal. It just looks like a little anchor. Bring down the decimal. So we had an answer of 1 and 53 hundredths. We're going to check by looking at my estimate. So 1 and 53 hundredths is close to 2, so we know that we probably got it right. Another way to check is you can actually add. You can take your answer or your difference, add it to 4.37, and if you do it right, you should get 5.9. So that's another way to check our answer. All right, let's try another one because you'll see a lot like this in fifth grade. $20 minus $14.76. Now, on the $20, there's no decimal. So what we have to do is we have to add a decimal. But first, we're going to estimate. So step 1 is to estimate. So $20 rounds to $20. $14.76 is close to $15. 20 minus 15 is about 5. So if we do this right, we should get an answer of around 5. Now, like I said, the $20 doesn't have a decimal. If you don't see it, it means it's at the end. So all you have to do is add a decimal at the end and then line up the decimals. Well, I got to add 2 zeros to make them line up. Okay. And then we're going to have to borrow. So there's nothing to borrow from here. There's nothing here. I got to go all the way to 2 to borrow. That becomes a 1, and then I give it to this person or this place. That becomes a 10. I'm going to borrow from that, becomes a 9. This becomes a 10. Borrow from that. That becomes a 9. So now I have something over here to borrow from. 10 minus 6 is 4. 9 minus 7 is 2. 9 minus 4 is 5. And then the next step, we circle the sign, is to drop the anchor. So we can check it. We got an answer of 5 and 24 hundredths, which is close to our estimate of 5. Or I can add it. I can add 5.24 and 14.76, and I should get $20, which I did. All right, so now it's your turn to practice. And remember, subtracting decimals is a lot like subtracting whole numbers. So just subtract like you would normally, and then just add the decimal at the end. All right, now it's your turn to try. Good luck.